I just got my 24-volt, 80-pound thrust Minn Kota Ultrex back in service by replacing the main control board. But now I have another issue that might have contributed to the downfall of that control board in the first place. So the issue I'm having is I got the prop spinning again, which is great, but when I go to my lower speeds, it either won't engage, or if I have it engaged at, like, say, a speed 5 and I turn it down below a 3, it just stops. So that's telling me I got something going on in my lower unit. Something just ain't right. When I pulled the big long through bolts, I could see a little bit of corrosion on there and some funk. So I'm thinking I might have got a little bit of water intrusion in there. So before I go and field test this motor to make sure that new control board is working, I'm gonna replace the whole seal kit on the lower unit. And if the armature looks at all funky, I'm gonna replace that as well. Let's get into it. So the obvious part I don't really need to show you is you gotta remove your prop, and then you gotta remove the two through bolts that come through here, and then you'll be able to crack the whole unit apart. I was able to pull that armature out. It takes a little bit of elbow grease, but you can get it out. It's definitely funky. I think it can be cleaned up, but I've already ordered a new one. I'll probably clean that one up and keep it as a spare. Looks like I have a couple of bolts that are retaining this brush plate onto this assembly. And I think the easiest way to do it, hopefully it's that same 6mm socket. I'm just going to reach through the whole unit. That magnetic field in there makes that quite challenging. But it is that 6mm socket. Okay. Got that apart. Look on this brush plate. I have a positive and a negative that have a blade connector. And the brushes are also on blade connectors. Once I get that positive and negative pulled off, this brush plate should come out. I'm gonna leave them in place until I have my new stuff, just so I know where to put my connections on my new one. So I'm gonna shut it down for today. When the new parts show up, we'll fire it back up and I'll show you how to put all this back together correctly. Well, it's about a week later. Got all my parts and my supplies. We need to come back over here and finish this disassembly before we can get to reassembling everything. So we don't have much play here. So we're gonna have to buy ourselves some room by disconnecting some wires. Got 11 F-15 flyover. America. Well, it looks like I'm cleaning up my circuit board then. So my positive and negatives are soldered to the brush board. So while I'm able to remove the brushes and their leads, I cannot get my positive and negative wires off. So I'm gonna take these bolts out because they need a cleaning. They are pretty rusted. And this one that's over by the power wires has a little ground on it. Take care with that guy. Now I should be able to take my brush springs, move them aside, and pull my brushes right out. It is funky in here, so I'm going to clean that out with brake cleaner. If you ain't going to wear gloves, that's fine. You're a grown-ass man, I assume you do what you want. Do wear your eye protection though, man. This stuff splashes back in your eyes, it's going to ruin your day. I'm also gonna clean out my end cap here with some brake cleaner. It's got some funk in it too. Okay, she ain't pretty like new, but that's pretty darn good. This cleaner sure goes away quick. It's so hot out here, I looked down when I was setting up the cameras and my shadow was trying to run away. So I really wanted to use this new board. Since those blade fittings are soldered on there, it just makes my life hard. And the board ain't broken. The springs are still springy. So I think we're just gonna go with it. What's super nice is my kit came with new bolts, so I don't have to clean those old ones up that were all funky. All the brushes are out. I'm gonna get this bolt. I'm gonna be sure to go through that little grounding strap. And then I'll get my other side. I think I'm gonna replace the springs too. Since they gave me new ones, I'm gonna do it. Stay up there. Okay. I'm gonna slip a brush in there. Reconnect our lead. That moves really nice. Positive brush in. GoPro overheated, so I had to make some shade for it. We're back. Okay, so positive brush. I'm connecting power. Okay, brushes are in, springs are in. Both brushes move quite nicely, so we're good there. At this point, I'm going to take this brush spring and I'm just going to pull it up out of the way so it's not or maybe I'll go down, see if it'll hold down. Nope. Okay, we're just gonna move that spring up and out of its channel so that the brush can move back. Hopefully that's showing up good in the camera. What that does is allow you the slack for your stator assembly to fit in there. Now we're gonna work on our prop seals. I have a feeling this is where my complications came from. I think what might be easiest here is just using a punch and taking them out from the backside. We'll see. Yeah, that's gonna work. Normally I do this on a workbench, but I want you to be able to see what's going on here. It takes a little bit of effort. Okay, so that guy comes out, and then some have this and some don't. I think most do have this little cardboard piece of tubing in there. I did not get a new one of those, so I'm gonna set that aside. Okay, with both of these seals, the cup side goes out towards the prop. Remember that. Okay, I was able to extract that with a pick. Lucky. I'm gonna clean out this race here with some brake cleaner real quick. And that little bit of brake cleaner that got in that little bit of a cut I just made with that pick feels really good. I feel so alive right now. My hands are so sweaty, all my fingers have a reservoir tip. Okay, gloves aren't necessary for this, but I'm gonna be using some grease, so I'm doing it. And while I'm pulling seals, in these little holes, you might find your little O-rings for those through bolts. One other seal we're gonna remove is the big guy right here. That one's trash now. And I'm just gonna run my pick through the little chase that it sits in. Mostly what I'm doing is not so much cleaning as I'm feeling for pitting. If I feel pitting in there, then that's a source of a leak, and instead of using grease when I reassemble, I would use a sealant. But she's feeling good. Okay, we are ready for new seals. So a silicone grease or a white lithium grease is pretty good right here. I'm using white lithium grease. Just gonna go ahead and grease up that chase. Now they make tools for this, I don't have it. So I'm using an 18 millimeter socket. You'll feel when it's seated. Okay, then I'm gonna take that little cardboard tube piece, fit that one back in. Put some grease on my second seal. Grease up that chase again. And like the first one, cup side out. Grab my socket and my hammer again. There we go. Okay, seals are in place. I'm gonna flip it over. Now we got the seal out here, the big guy. I'm gonna apply a little bit of grease all around here. And the main purpose of this grease is to hold that seal in place while all this gets reassembled. But it will help in creating a good seal as well. And we take our new seal. Just slide down right in place. Don't forget, before we affix this brush plate, to fit these little sleeves on your bolts. Then skeg side down. I'm just gonna start these bolts by hand. Those bolt sleeves are important because they keep you from over tightening all this and breaking that brush board. So I got my springs out of the way. I've moved my brushes. Now we can go the other side. Okay, now into this nose cup where I applied that grease. We have a spacer and two crowned washers. These crowned washers, you want to make it to where the crowns face each other so these can rock. And what that's going to do is provide a little bit of cushion for the bearing assembly. And those are just going to drop right in here. I'm just going to cover them with that grease. It's going to help hold them in place. Now we're going to take our new armature. Now if you notice these blue globs on there, those are supposed to be there. Do not pick them off. It's been balanced at the factory, and that's how they balance it. Yours should come with that C-clip or E-clip. You might need to take that old washer off. There's supposed to be a Nylotron washer there too. Mine got chewed up, I guess. It was not there. Now I'll leave the plastic bag on there just so I don't get any grease anywhere it's not supposed to be. And what we're gonna do is we're gonna go ahead and fit this in. Okay, before we go ahead and put that armature in, I'm just triple checking again. My brushes are out of the way and I have my springs off to the side. They're actually kind of helping hold those out of the way. Try and hold that in place. And then as I put this armature in, the magnets are gonna grab it and pull it in. So this could take you a couple of tries. Just like that. And now I can take my new O-rings for my through bolts. I'm gonna fit them on. Get my other through bolt prepared. Up here just so it can slide on there instead of trying to roll in. All right, well, our stator in place. Very important, we don't forget. Put these springs back. That's what puts your brushes in place. Gonna get our nose cup in place, orient it where it should be. With the shaft seal in place. Okay, now what I'm gonna do is I'm gonna take this out of the cradle and I'm gonna orient it horizontally, make it a little easier on myself. All right, once those are started, I can put her back in the cradle. Get my skeg and my bolts in line with my shaft. Then I'm gonna square up the nose cone to that. Alright, all back together, time to give her a test. Got her power hooked back up. Got power to the foot pedal. Got her out of the cradle. We hit our momentary switch. She's running like a champ. It's a pretty easy repair you can do with basic tools. I'm gonna get out of the shade because I am dying. I am not a mechanic. I am not a trolling motor technician. I'm just a handy guy. I was able to do this with really basic tools in not a lot of time. It's not even that expensive. I think just the rebuild kit for the bottom was 60 bucks. I don't remember exactly. I'll try and put links in the description for any tools you might need and the equipment that it took to do this job. Hope it gives you confidence to go do it yourself. Get out there, go get them.